Good morning, children. And today we are continuing with the Merchant of Venice. In the last session, Antonio was very depressed. The jailer brought him out to see Shylock so that he could plead for mercy one more time. Thought of Shylock cutting a pound of flesh from his body, that also nearest the heart, made him very sad and filled with despair. So today we will continue from there. And we have seen that Shylock refuses to show any mercy towards Antonio. Act 3, Scene 4, page 142. Bell went a room in Portia's house. Enter Portia, Nerissa, Lorenzo, Jessica and Balthasar. Lorenzo, madam, I speak it in your presence. I'm telling you in front of you. You have a noble and true conceit of godlike amity. You are very noble. You have a good character, a virtuous character. You're not at all selfish. You're very noble. And true conceit, you understand things very well. Conceit here means understanding. You have a noble and true conceit of godlike amity. The understanding, the concern which you show for others is almost like God. Godlike amity. Amity here is friendship, but here is the concern, the love which you show for others. Is almost resembling the love and forgiveness of God, which appears most strongly in bearing thus the absence of your Lord. So this sacrifice which you are making in allowing Bassanio immediately after your wedding to go to Venice to save his friend shows that you are very unselfish and you understand the difficulties and problems of others, which appears most strongly in bearing thus the absence of your Lord. But if you knew to whom you show this honor, if you realize whom you are helping, the kind of man that you are sending help to, if you knew that. Now Portia has not seen Antonio. And she does not know Antonio except from what she had heard Bassanio speak about him. But still, she wants to do everything to save him. But if you knew to whom you show this honor, how true a gentleman you send relief. How true, a real gentleman. Now a gentleman has all good qualities. He is polite, he is honorable, he is respected. He has concern for others. So the word gentleman itself shows that he possesses all good qualities which a man should possess. How true a gentleman. He is very truthful. He is honest. He is ready to sacrifice everything for his friend, that is Antonio. How true a gentleman you send relief. Relief, you are sending help. You are sending comfort. How dear a lover of my Lord, your husband. How attached Antonio and Bassanio are to each other. They are very close friends and they love each other so much. How dear a lover of my Lord, your husband. Lorenzo is saying my Lord, referring to Bassanio, and your husband, Portia's husband. I know you would be prouder of your work than customary bounty can enforce. So if you knew to whom you are sending this help, such a virtuous, such a good man, you will be prouder of the work that you are doing. You will be prouder of your generosity towards this gentleman whom you have not seen, whom you have only heard about. Then customary bounty can enforce you. Customary means usual. Bounty is generosity. So you will be prouder of this generous act which you are doing, that is sending Bassanio to Venice to help Antonio, then it is you will be prouder than the usual acts of kindness which you are doing to others. Portia, I never did repent for doing good. I never felt sorry. I never regretted for doing good to others, nor shall not now. Now I will not have any regretful feelings. For in companions that do converse and waste the time together, waste your spend time together. Companions means friends. Converse means talk to each other. They spend time. For in companions that do converse and waste the time together. Here it refers to Antonio and Bassanio. They spend a lot of time together. They have spent a lot of time together. Whose souls do bear an equal yoke of love. The love which these two friends have for each other is the same. The same amount of love they have for each other. Whose souls do bear an equal yoke of love. Yoke is what you put on the necks of two oxen when they plow the field. And both these oxen have to walk at the same pace. Then only the field will be plowed properly. Here, both of them have equal love for each other. Whose souls do bear an equal yoke of love? There must be needs a like proportion of lineaments, of manners, and of spirit. So these two friends, Antonio and Bassanio, are so much attached to each other that Portia feels that they both will have the same character, the same nature, the same behavior. So in all these respects also, they will resemble each other. There must be needs a like proportion, means both of them will be similar in their character, lineaments, manners, and of spirit. They will have all the characteristics. Which makes me think that this Antonio, being the bosom lover of my Lord, so I think that Antonio, since Antonio and Bassanio love each other so much, being the bosom lover of my Lord, must needs be like my Lord. So, in seeing Bassanio, she is also looking at Antonio. Because they are such close friends and they will resemble each other in their character, behavior, nature. So, in helping Antonio, Portia feels that she is also helping Bassanio. Because they are so close to each other. Which makes me think that this Antonio, being the bosom lover of my Lord, must needs be like my Lord. So must resemble my Lord is Bassanio. If it be so, if it is this, if things are like this, that is Bassanio and Antonio resemble each other. If it be so, how little is the cost I have bestowed in purchasing the semblance of my soul from out the state of hellish cruelty. Hellish cruelty refers to the cruelty of Shylock, insisting on the pound of flesh. So in saving Antonio, Portia feels that she is saving Bassanio himself. And she is doing only very little because she loves Bassanio so much and she feels that she is not doing much. She is doing only what she should do to help Antonio, to save him from the clutches of Shylock. How little is the cost? I am doing only very little. How little is the cost I have bestowed, I am doing, in purchasing the semblance of my soul. Semblance of my soul means one who is like me. Now, Bassanio and Portia have got married and they are one. They resemble each other. So, Bassanio and Antonio also resemble each other in many ways. In their character and behavior, they resemble each other. So she is saving somebody whom Bassanio loves very much. and she feels that she is doing only very little. How little is the cost I have bestowed in purchasing the semblance of my soul, in saving a person who is so much like my husband, in purchasing the semblance of my soul from out the state of hellish cruelty. Notice the word hellish cruelty, from the cruel clutches of Shylock. This comes too near the praising of myself. Now I have been praising myself and I don't want to praise myself at all. Portia is very modest. She is very humble also. Therefore, no more of it. I don't want to speak any of these things anymore. But let us come to important matters. Therefore, no more of it. Hear other things. I have important things to decide and tell you. Lorenzo, I commit into your hands the husbandry and manage of my house. I am handing over to you, that is to Lorenzo, the full control of my house. Now, why does she trust Lorenzo so much? Because Lorenzo is also a friend of Bassanio. And in trusting Lorenzo, she feels that she is trusting Bassanio himself. So that is why she has just seen Lorenzo for the first time. And she is prepared to hand over all the control of her house, her servants, everything that she has into the hands of Lorenzo. Therefore, no more of it. Here other things. Lorenzo, I commit into your hands the husbandry and manage of my house. Husbandry means the control and management of my house until my lord's return. Till Bassanio returns, you can be the master of this house. So notice her goodness. This is something which normally a person would not do. Until my lord's return, till Bassanio returns. For mine own part, as far as I am concerned, I have towards heaven breathed a secret vow. I have made a promise to God. And it is a secret promise. What is that promise? To live in prayer and contemplation. To spend that time in prayer and meditation until her husband and my lord's return. Until Bassanio and Graziano return from Venice to Belmont, Portia has decided to take Nerissa with her and spend all the time in prayer and meditation. Meditation means thinking about doing good. There is a monastery 2 miles off. There is a religious house which is only 2 miles away. And there we will abide. Abide means stay. We will remain there. We will stay there. I do desire you not to deny this imposition. Imposition is the command, the order to take full charge of Portia's house and servants. So she's saying, I hope you will not refuse this work, this command which I am giving you. This task, imposition, more than command, it is the work or the task, the which my love and some necessity now lays upon you. I am asking you to do this